He's ready. Noah Lyles is ready. Italy, though, out on the outside with Marcel Jacobs on the second leg. Courtney Lindsay got the US off to an absolute flyer yesterday. Lebezeze will be trying to do the same for France in lane six. Aaron Brown, reliable opening leg runner for Canada, is in five. Japan with Shoma Yamamoto in four. Inside them, Wu Zhijiang of China. Richard Kilty for Great Britain. He was on the third leg yesterday. He runs the opening bend in this one. And Brian Lavelle comes in for Jamaica. This was the only team for Jamaica to reach a final yesterday. Time for some of the powerhouses. The men's 4x100 metres relay final here in Nassau. Courtney Lindsay of the USA was the fastest out of the blocks yesterday and has started well again, already up on Italy, who are about to hand the ball on to Marcel Jacobs. USA changed a decent one. Kenny Benderek is up on Marcel Jacobs. Outside him, Canada are going well. On the second leg for them is Jerome Blake. USA on the outside, Kyrie King has the baton. Italy outside them, Canada coming through ahead of Britain and Northern Ireland, right on the inside as well. But it's Noah Lyles with the baton in hand at the moment, and surely there's an unassailable lead for Noah Lyles. Andre de Grasse in second place, and Italy in third with Filippo Torto. But the USA complete a hat-trick here in the Bahamas as Noah Lyles, the world champion, brings them home ahead of Canada and Italy. Well, like we said earlier on, if you give the baton to someone of that quality in that position, there was going to be no other result. 37.40, the USA absolutely flying, only 200th of a second outside their championship record from 9 years ago. Andre de Grasse had a good final leg as well, but there was no way Daphne was catching Noah Lyles.
No, that's one of the things that's very difficult, I think. When you know that they are in front and Noah Lyles is coming, then you know that that must be a difficult thing. But de Grasse is really, really strong leg, because he can close it, but he can just, do the same distance, I think. And that's very important for him to know.
Well, Marcel Jacobs didn't really have too much chance to make much of an impact because he was down when he got the baton. The USA right alongside them in lane 7 and 8 out there. He was up against Kenny Bednarek down the back straight, who had probably a 5 metre or so head start on Marcel Jacobs down the back straight. But the USA flags, the stars and stripes, have been getting plenty of airtime in the course of the last 20 minutes or so. We've had three finals and the United States have won them all. And given their history in relays, Daphne, when they haven't always got the baton round, some USA fans will be pleasantly surprised to see such a level of success for them tonight. Canada taking the silver medal. Again, we talked about them previously as the ultimate championship performers, really. The Olympic silver medal winning quartet didn't make the final in Budapest in the World Championships. And Italy, the Olympic champions, of course, the world silver medalists, weren't able with their Olympic champion team, three of their Olympic champion team, including the individual winner, Marcel Jacobs, to make an impact. So USA have won all three so far. We've got the two 4x400 metres finals to come. They're in both of those in seeded lanes as well. Could the USA go 5 out of 5 in the finals? So Italy are folding up their flags and giving them back. Oh, they're passing on to their teammates. Not wild celebrations of the Italians at the moment down there. Eventually we'll get their medals around their neck. We'll get a replay in just a moment of how that race unfolded. Lyles, a bit like Simbini earlier on when he was given the baton in a commanding lead. The positions weren't going to change when you've got runners all of high, high calibre on the final leg. A lot of the work has been done by the three previous runners. They're almost like a family now, those four, aren't they, for Canada? It wouldn't be a 4x100 metre relay team if any of them weren't there. Ultimately, one day they won't be, but at the minute, they're riding high for Canada with second place. It's another brilliant opening leg from Courtney Lindsay, isn't it? Who's given them such an advantage over Jacobs here down the back straight.
It was a very fast first leg.
Look at Benarek.
But also Jacobs is running really good here because he was on the same position and that was really good as well.
It's a brilliant leg. And look at that, not the cleanest change between Benarek and Kyrie King. Italy was smooth on the outside. But no real momentum lost. Kyrie King running another good bend. And that was well-drilled stuff from the USA. And just that final change, that sense of relief when you get the baton in the hand of the anchor leg runner. And if that runner happens to be Noah Lyles, you probably feel even better. Let's have a look at how smooth this was again from them. Pretty good. Room for improvement, you'd say, but pretty good.
Yeah, it's good enough because they don't need to take any risk of it because they are a very fast team, so then you need to take any risk.
Room for improvement if you've got really, really high standards. But Lyles again, all out towards the line. Again, I'd be fascinated to see how the splits come out for that one. He ran 8 point something yesterday, even though splits are relatively meaningless. 8.88 for Noah Lyles on that final leg. Italy coming up as a disqualification.